The subject is Database Management System. Today we will learn about the relational algebra. The agenda for today is, we will quickly revisit relational model, relational algebra, learn about certain relational algebra operations such as select, project, union, difference, cross product, join, rename, and at the end we'll try to do certain queries based on relational algebra. So as we know, database is a collection of interrelated data and consists of multiple relations. For example, if you are supposed to store some information about an enterprise, the enterprise may contain data about the instructor, the student, the department. So we can have three relations, one for instructor, one for student, and one for department in our database. The relation schema, as we know, is defined by capital R, which consists of n number of attributes, A1, A2, A3, and so on till AN. So here we have a relation R with n number of attributes. For example, instructor is a relation with 4 attributes: ID of the instructor, name of the instructor, department name, and the salary. Just the example, when we enter the data into the table, here we have 4 attributes: ID, name, department name, and salary. And these are the rows which are called tuples in a relation. So these are the tuples, and each tuple stores the information about an instructor. So first tuple represents the information about the first instructor, whose ID is 10101, the name is Srinivasan, department name is computer science, and the salary he draws is 65,000. Now let's learn about relational algebra. Relational algebra is a set of operations that take relation instances as arguments and return new relations. So in relational algebra, we have a number of operators. These operators take relations as arguments, and the results of these queries are again relations. Now this is a procedural language, and thus we say that it's a procedural method of specifying a retrieval query. So when we write a query, we have to specify what do we want and how to get it. So we specify both what to get and how to get it. So it is a procedural method. Now, SQL queries that we write are internally translated into relational algebra expressions. It provides a framework for query optimization. So, let us now learn few operators. These are some relational algebra operators. First is select, project, union, difference, cross product, join, and rename. These are the relational algebra operators, and let us learn them one by one. Select operator. This is a unary operator. It also takes the relation as the input, and the result will again be a relation, which is applicable for all the operators. This select operator is used to select the tuples from the operations depending upon the certain conditions that are specified. So, select operator, which is represented by sigma, will retrieve tuples from the relations based upon the condition that we have specified. Now, sigma, theta, r. So here r is the relation and sigma shows that we want to retrieve tuples from the relation r. And theta is the condition that we specify. So, all those tuples in the relation R that satisfy the condition theta will be retrieved by sigma or select operator. So, sigma will retrieve the tuples from the relation R based upon the condition theta specified. And as we know, the result of such a query will again be a relation. And the schema of that result will be same as the schema of the relation R. Let us learn about the conditions, the theta. There are certain basic conditions. This is the way you can specify theta. That is any condition. You may say AI and use certain comparison operator and then another attribute AJ. Or you can say AI and use a comparison operator and write a constant. Here, the operators can be less than equal to, greater than equal to, or not equal to. So you may say that where date of joining is greater than date of birth. So date of joining is an attribute, say AI, and date of birth is an attribute, say AJ, and greater than will be the operator here. Or you may say age is greater than 25. So age is AI, greater than is the operator, and 25 is the constant. Let us take an example. Find the information about a professor whose name is Ram. Read this query carefully. Find the information. Here, we mean to say that we want all the attributes about a professor. So, when we want to select all the information, we mean to say that we want the complete tuple. And for this, we have sigma or select operator. Now, information about the professor, which is stored in professor table. So the relation is professor. Now the condition. The condition here is that the name of the professor should be Ram. So we write the condition, the attribute name is equal to Ram. So sigma, professor relation, and the condition is Ram. So we write sigma, name is equal to Ram, from the relation professor. So this is how select operator works, and this is a basic condition. We can also have a combination or composition of some basic conditions. It means that we may need to retrieve tuples where there are more than one conditions. So, these basic conditions can be combined using certain logical operations. Logical operations may be AND or NOT. Let's take an example. Find the information about a professor who joined the university between 1980 and 1985. So, we write sigma, and then there are two conditions. One condition is that the starting year should be greater than or equal to 1980. Another condition is start year should be less than 1985. So, we combine these two basic conditions using this AND logical operator. So, sigma, start year is greater than 1980 and start year is less than 1985 from professor relation. Let us take another example. Let R be a relation with four attributes A, B, C and D. And let this relation contain four tuples. If you write the query, sigma A is equal to B and D is greater than 5 from the relation R, we mean to say that we want the tuples from the relation R where the value of the attribute A is equal to the value of attribute B in that tuple, and also the value of the attribute D is greater than 5. So, all those tuples which satisfy both these conditions will only be retrieved. So, let us see. Let us consider the first tuple. So, is the value of A and B common? Is it equal? So, in the first tuple, we have alpha as A and alpha as B. So, the value of both A and B are equal. Let us see if B is greater than 5. So, the value 7 in the first tuple is greater than 5. So, the first tuple of the relation R satisfies both these conditions. Now, coming to the second tuple, the value of A and B are alpha and beta. So, they are not same. They are not equal. So, one of the conditions is not satisfied. Hence, we will not have second tuple in our result. Let us take the third tuple. Here, the value of A is equal to the value of B, but the value of D is not greater than 5. Since one of these conditions is not satisfied, we will also not have the tuple 3 in our result. Let us take tuple 4. The value of A and B are equal and the value of D, that is 10, is greater than 5. So, tuple number 4 also satisfies both these conditions. And hence, tuple number 1 and tuple number 4 will be present in the resultant table. So, the result will be, as we know, the resultant relation will have the same schema as the original relation. So, we again have four attributes here in the result, and the two tuples which satisfied these both conditions. So, this is how a select operator works. Let us move to another operator, that is project operator. This is also a unary operator and it is used to retrieve only the attributes from the relations. We can select few attributes of our choice from the relation and rest of the attributes will not be retrieved. So whenever we want to retrieve only specific attributes from a relation, we should use project operator. The notation is pi. Pi represents project operator. So, if we write pi and give a list of attributes as a1, comma a2, comma till ak from a relation R, we will retrieve only these specified attributes from the relation R. So, if R1 is equal to pi capital L R2, where capital L is the list of attributes, then again the scheme of R1 is L. The scheme of R1 means this is the result that we have received after this query has been executed. So, the scheme of R1 will be, which means that the attributes in the result R1 will be the attributes specified in this list. Let us take an example to understand this project expression. Let student be a table with three attributes, roll number, name and degree. And here are the six tuples as you see. If we write a query pi to select pi roll number comma name and within bracket student. So we are trying to project two attributes, roll number and name only from the relation student. The resultant relation will be this one, which contains only the columns that we have specified in the query expression. So we see that this contains only roll number and the name and it ignores the degree column. So we'll have all the tuples but with only the attributes that we specified in the query expression. Let us combine project with sigma. Let's understand it with this example. If my query is pi name from sigma degree is equal to ms from student. Now, here you can see that sigma degree is equal to ms from student is enclosed in a bracket. So, since this is the inner query, it will be executed first. When we say sigma degree is equal to ms from student, this will retrieve the tuples where degree is equal to ms. Let us see. The first tuple contains degree, which is ms. Another tuple, second, and the last one. So, first, second, and last tuples will be retrieved out of this inner query. Now, out of these tuples, we are interested only in the names. So, here we are trying to find the name of those students who hold the degree MS. So, first, we have retrieved the tuples where the degree was MS, and thereafter We retrieved only the names from those tuples. So, we have the name from first, second and last tuple. So, the names are Mahesh, Rajesh, and since Mahesh is coming repeatedly, it will not be shown into the result. So, the result will be Mahesh and Rajesh. Now again, the result of the query is again a set. Therefore, it will not hold any duplicate values. There are certain set operations in relational algebra. Union, intersection and difference. These are the three operations we will learn one by one. Now, these operators are applicable to two relations. These are binary operators. So, these are applicable to two relations, and if there are schemas are union compatible. This is important. Union compatible. We can perform union, intersection and difference on relations, but only when they are union compatible. Now, what do we mean by union compatibility? Let us consider two relations, R1 and R2, and R1 has the attribute A1, A2 to AK, and R2 has the attribute B1, B2, BM. So, R1 and R2 are union compatible only if K is equal to M. This means that the number of attributes in both the relations R1 and R2 should be the same. Second condition, domain AI should be equal to domain BI, which means that the domain of A1 should be same as the domain of B1. Domain of A2 should be same as the domain of B2, and so on. So, to be union compatible, the two relations should have equal number of attributes, and the domains of the corresponding attributes should be the same. Let us understand, R1 is a relation with scheme R1, and let us have another relation R2. And R1 is union compatible with R2, which again means that the number of attributes in R1 is same as the number of attributes in R2, and their domains of the corresponding attributes are the same. So, this represents the union operator R1 union R2. So, when we perform union of the relations R1 and R2, the resultant relation will have the tuples which either belong to R1 or belong to R2. So, here you can see the result of union of R1 and R2 are the tuples where the tuple belongs to R1 or a tuple belongs to R2. So, it will combine all the tuples that are present in R1 and R2. Intersection. Here, R1 intersection R2 will give us the tuples which belong to R1 and R2. So only those tuples will be retrieved which are present in both R1 and R2. Which means that only the common tuples will be retrieved. In case of difference, R1 minus R2 will give us the tuples which are present in R1 but are not present in R2. So you can see that tuples belongs to R1 and tuple does not belong to R2. So those tuples which are present in R1 but which are not present in R2 will be the result of R1 minus R2. This is difference. Let's take an example of union. If this is a relation R and this is the relation S, let us see what R union S will hold for us. Here we have a tuple alpha 1, beta 2, beta 1. Here we have another tuple alpha 2 and beta 3. So R union S will have all the tuples from R and S. So we have here the tuples which are present in either R or S. Alpha and 1. This is present in the union. Then alpha and 2. Beta 2. Beta and 3. Intersection operation. Let this be R, this be S. So R intersection S will hold only the common tuple. So let us see which is the common tuple which is present in both R and S. So alpha and 1, it is present in R but it is not present in S. Alpha and 2, it is present in R and it is also present in S. So we have alpha and 2 in R intersection S. Beta and 1 is present in R but it is not present in S. Therefore, the resultant query, the resultant relation holds only one tuple that exists in both R and S. The set difference. So if this is R and this is S, R minus S will give us only those tuples which are present in R but not present in S. Let us consider the first tuple alpha 1. This is present in R but it is not present in S. So here we have alpha and A. The second tuple alpha and 2 is present in R but it is also present in S. So we will not have it in the result. The tuple beta and 1 is present in R but it is not present in S. So it will also be present in the result. Let us study another operator, that is Cartesian product. The notation is R cross S. And R cross S is equal to P cube, where P belongs to R and Q belongs to S. It is a combination of all the tuples that belongs to R and All those belongs to S. So here PQ is the number of tuples that the cross product of R and S will hold. So if there are two tuples in R and three tuples in S, the cross product R and S will hold 2 into 3, that is 6 tuples. Here we assume that the attributes of R and S are disjoint, which means no attribute is common in R and S. In case the R and S has some attribute in common, those common attributes will have to be renamed. So we can say, if an attribute age is common in R and S, you can rename them as R dot age and S dot age. Let's take an example. Let this be R and this relation be S. Number of tuples in relation R, as we can see, are 2 and here it is 4. So 2 into 4, in the resultant table, we'll have 8 tuples. And the number of attributes here you can see are 2, A and B. And here we have 3, C, D and E. So number of attributes in R cross S will be a combination of all these. That means A, B, C, D and E. Now here, every tuple of relation R will be combined with each tuple of S. Let us see. The first tuple is alpha 1. We combine with the first tuple, which is alpha 10 and A. So, the first tuple in the resultant query is alpha A, which comes from R, and alpha 10 and A, which comes from S. Again, alpha 1 will be combined with the second tuple giving beta 10 and A. So the second tuple is alpha 1, beta 10 and A. Again, first tuple is combined with the third, combined with fourth, and we get four tuples here. Thereafter, the second tuple of R will be combined with all these tuples of S. So we get beta 2 alpha 10 A here. We get beta 2 beta 10 A here as beta 2 beta 10 A and so on. So this is how we get the Cartesian product of the two relations. We may also combine these expressions, these operations, as we are doing here now. This is R cross S that we got previously by combining R with S. Let's perform a sigma operation on this resultant query. So we write sigma A is equal to C from R cross S. So from this R cross S, sigma means retrieving tuples. So we are retrieving the tuples which satisfy the condition that the value of A is equal to the value of C. Let us see whether tuple 1 satisfies the condition. In tuple 1, the value of A is equal to the value of C. It's alpha and alpha. So, we get this tuple in the result. Alpha 1, alpha 10 and A. In tuple 2, The value of A, that is alpha, is not equal to the value of C, which is beta. So we will not get this tuple in the relation. Similarly, here the value of A, of the attribute A, is equal to the value of attribute C. We have beta and beta. So we will have this tuple in the result. Here also the value of A is equal to the value of C. So we have again this tuple in the relation. In this way, from this cross product R and S, we retrieve the tuples, first tuple, this tuple, and again this. So we have three tuples in which the value of A was found to be equal to the value of C. Hence we get the relation. Rename operation. Sometimes we need to rename our relations. So we have an operator which is denoted by a row, and it allows us to name and therefore to refer to the results of the relational algebra expressions. So here, when we use rename operation, the same relation can be referred to by more than one names. If I write row X and within bracket E, here E is the relation and X is the new name I have given to the relation E. It means that the relation E has two names now. One is E and the other one is X. So, it returns the expression capital E under the name X. Another operation is join operation. Join is a combination of Cartesian product and sigma or selection. So, it combines the tuples from two relations provided they satisfy a specified conditions. So first we perform Cartesian product, and upon that, from that we select the tuples. So upon Cartesian product we apply selection and we get the join of the relations. Depending on the type of conditions, we have theta join and equi join. Let us see what theta join is. Let R1 be a relation with attributes A1 to AM, and R2 be a relation with attributes B1 to BN. The notation for join expression, as you can see, is R1 join R2, and theta gives you the condition on the basis of which you perform the join operation. So when you say R1 join R2 and the condition is theta, we first take the Cartesian product of R1 with R2 and apply select operation based upon the condition given in theta. So this theta is the join condition, which can be in the form of condition C1 and condition C2 and so on till CS. So any condition CI is again of the form AJ, comparison operator, BK, and these operators may be equal to, not equal to, less than equal to, greater than equal to. We can use any of these operations in case of theta join. But this is not the case with equi join. When we say equi join, only equal to operator is allowed. So equality is the only comparison operator used in the join condition. Let us take the condition R1 dot X1 is equal to R2 dot X2. Now here X1. Now observe carefully that here there are two relations R1 and R2, and both of them have the attribute with the same name, that is X1. So we write, in order to differentiate between the two, we write it as R1 dot X1 is equal to R2 dot X1. It shows that this X1 belongs to R1 and this X1 belongs to R2. So this is how we specify the joint condition. R1 dot X1 is equal to R2 dot X1, and R1 dot X2 is equal to R2 dot X2, and R1 dot X3 is equal to R2 dot X3. So here the values of these common attributes should be equal. So only when the common attributes hold the equal values, only then the tuples will be retrieved. For example, let us take two tables. One is department, another is course. Department holds department ID, the name of the department, HOD of the department, and the HOD and the department's phone number. Courses holds the detail about the courses offered, that is course ID, course name, credits, and department number. That means department which offers this course. Now, let us consider this query. If we have to find each department, from each department, its name and the name, sex, and phone number of the head HOD, what will be done? We'll have to perform a cross product between these two. A Cartesian product will be taken, and then equation will be performed on this basis. So, first we take Cartesian product of department with professor, where employee ID is equal to HOD and department number is equal to department ID. So, today we have learned various relational algebra operations such as select. Here select operator selects the tuples from the relations based upon the conditions that we have specified. Project operator will select the attributes that we have specified. Union will combine the tuples from two relations, and the condition is that both these relations should be union compatible. In difference, if we perform difference on R1 and R2, the result will hold only those tuples which are present in R1 and not present in R2. In the case of cross product of R1 and R2, the result will hold all combinations of the tuples in R1 and R2. The join operator is a combination of cross product and selection. So first, the cross product will be performed on R1 and R2, and then selection will be applied to the result of Cartesian product. Rename is the operation that is used to give another name to the relation. Hence, after we rename the relation R, it will be referred by two names. One is R and one is the new name that we have given it. Let us take a banking example in which we have these relations as specified here and perform certain queries on these relations. These are the queries that you can perform as assignments. Find all loans of over $1,200. So, find all loans, which means that we want all the information about the loans, and the condition is that the amount should be more than $1,200. So, the information about loan is given in the table loan. As you can see, loan has three attributes: loan number, branch name, and amount. So here, the condition should be that the amount should be greater than 1200. Find all loans of over $1,200. So, you'll have to apply select operator in order to retrieve the tuples where the condition will be that amount is greater than $1,200. Similarly, find the loan number for each loan. Now here we want only the loan number. So the hint is we have to apply PI operation here. For each loan of an amount greater than $1,200. So first, we'll perform select operation on the relation loan with the condition that amount is greater than 1200. Out of that, we will apply PI or project operation to get only the loan number. I'm sure you'll be able to write queries for all these queries specified. Third is find the names of all customers. So we want only the names. So again, we have to apply PI. Who have a loan? So the relation is again loan. An account or both from the bank. So we want the name of all those customers who have either taken a loan or they have an account or they have both a loan and account in the bank. Which means that such customers will be present in both the tables loan and account. Let us look at the schema. The details about the accounts of customers is stored in account relation. It has account number of all customers, branch name and balance, and the loan consists of loan number, branch name and amount. So here, we'll have to get information from two tables. One is account, one is loan. Account will give us the customers who hold an account in the bank, and loan will give the customers who have taken a loan from the bank. So using these two relations, we can perform query number 3. We have to use appropriate operators and get the result. The query 4, find the names of all customers who have a loan and an account. Means the customers who have taken loan as well as they have an account in the bank. Fifth one is to find the name of all customers who have a loan at the very rich branch. So we'll get the answer from loan. But here we have the loan number, branch name and account. So here branch name is given. So where the branch name is very rich, we have to find out the name of all customers. Last one, rename account relation as D. So we have to rename the relation account with D. I'm sure you will be able to perform these queries with the help of the relational algebra operations that we have learned today. You may refer these three books for relational operations.